Welcome to another episode of Wait and See, our favorite podcast. Hopefully it's climbing the charts for you too. My name is Ryan Holyoke, and I am joined with the amazing, phenomenal, incredible Casey Maurice Green.
Still not Maurice.
Still not Maurice.
Not even getting closer. Okay. Hey Ryan, how's it going?
Yeah, it's going really great. I feel pumped. I feel excited to be here. And we've got some interesting things I'm gonna talk to you about today.
Oh, jeez. Are you gonna make me cry? Are you gonna break me down?
I don't know if we'll cry in this one.
All right,
but
good.
I don't have the $5 bill that floats around for the office bet on which one of us will cry first.
They could not have chose two bigger crybabies for this journey than you and I.
It's been great. It's helped us to shed some extra ounces.
This is true.
Right? What a challenge.
What a challenge.
Yes. Super excited to be with you and to continue the conversation we've been talking about on this podcast, our health journey and how that's been connected to so many other aspects of our life as we've leveled up in health, how that's connected to our relationships, to our finances, all sorts of different areas, leveling up personal power, becoming our highest and best selves. We got a comment on our social recently from one of our friends, Josh, and it really got me thinking. And I'm going to see if I can get you thinking.
Josh.
Yeah. Thank you, Josh. It said, it sounds like you've done hundreds of breakthroughs with Kris and on your own to recreate your mentality. How do you not lose those? What do you do to keep or cement those new beliefs?
Yeah.
And I really liked this because it gave me this idea of momentum, right? There's so many times in all of our lives when something happens which causes something else or which leads to a situation which then starts things to be able to spiral out of control or things snowball. So I want to talk about today, Casey, with your permission.
Permission granted.
How do we reset? How do you arrest that momentum
and
redirect? So what types of things have you seen either on your health journey or just in your life that have gotten off track?
So there's a lot, right? So I think... you could talk about this really in any different aspect, right? Like your physical health, your relationships, at work, right? Like however you look at it, right? Like your food, our meal plan. How do we reset any of those when something goes awry, right? I'm going to turn it back over to MCT. So this really, it's an intriguing thing for me because first and foremost, when I get a breakthrough, for example, from Kris, right? Repetition is a huge thing for me. Right. So I make sure that I go through and I start using that mantra as often as I can in my head, right, to make sure that it's sticking. Right. And once it begins to stick, there's less of a chance it's going to fall away from like my thought process. Right. Yeah. I've even gone so far as to write stuff down. I have a journal that I have that I write random things in. And some pages are dedicated to me rewriting that thing multiple times so that I can get it to stick. Right. And if there's ever a moment where I'm like, wait a minute, what's going on here? Like I feel off. Right. I go back and I look and I say, here's why. Because I've veered from my new limiting belief, right? So for me, when it comes to like breakthroughs and how I hang on to them, a lot of times they're very, sometimes I don't need to. Sometimes they're very efficient and they're very impactful and it leaves a lasting memory enough that I don't have to worry about going back because I've actually changed my behavior, right? But if it's something like, I'm trying to think of an example. If it's something that takes a little more work, right? Yeah. I try to like notate that somewhere. I've been fortunate enough a couple of times to like grab Kris on an audio recording, right? So if I have struggles, I can go back and be in that moment because every time I have a breakthrough and I'm in that moment, I feel it so much,
yeah.
Right? And I leave that experience and I'm like, I am jazzed, I'm energized, I'm ready to go. New belief, right? And so sometimes I'm able to capture those and drop them in my audio or something or write them down in my book so that I always have a way to kind of go back and reference and really just connect again with that feeling. Right, because a lot of my breakthroughs that I go through are associated not just mentally, but there's a feeling that like you just deep down here, right?
Yeah.
That like you start to feel and you're like, oh yes, this is where I need to be. And so I'll reassociate that feeling and that mantra, right? That new belief together. And so that's helped me a lot to be able to, as far as breakthroughs go, like re-cement them or revisit them and feel that same feeling, if that makes sense.
Yeah. That's really interesting because that's pretty similar to how I've gone through the processes as well. And our CEO, Carson, he gives an amazing training to all of the new team members that we bring on board here at our company. And he actually demonstrates this similar idea where he has a note on his phone where he is writing that these new beliefs that he comes up with. And he is always in the process of finding new things that he wants to choose to believe. But one thing that I think came to mind as you were saying that, he talks a lot about how when you're using these new beliefs, you have to be able to use them like from a place of power.
Yeah.
And so he'll have that training group go through and write down a few of these new beliefs, these powerful things they want to choose to believe, but then he'll have them stand up, right? And we'll do like a Wonder Woman pose or some kind of like beast mode kind of thing so that that emotion gets ratcheted up. And I think that can be super helpful independent. Like if you haven't had the experience to go through to that place, to like that emotional place where you're recalling those feelings, you can simulate some of that emotion just by the way that you use your body, that physical, the physiology, I guess, that you bring in. So being able to do that. And if you have the ability to write things down in a journal, I think that can be super critical to connect the new belief with that experience where you originally cemented your limiting belief. So very, very good call outs there. How about for like your meal plans? If you feel like, you know, like you made some decisions and things were going good, but then for a number of other reasons, I feel like there's always reasons.
Yeah.
A number of reasons, some of your things are getting off track. How do you reset? How do you go back to try to re-cement those behaviors?
Yeah, so this one's a little bit easier for me, I would say, because we've been eating so clean and so strict for such a long time that when I start to, like, if, for example, I'm like, oh, I had a little bit of carbohydrates for lunch or something, like I need to cut back on my rice at dinner, and I choose a different kind of carbohydrates, like I have a very physical response now. So I'm like, oh, like I don't feel like my stomach doesn't feel good. Like I need to like, and so that's always kind of a nice nudge for me to like go back and say, okay, what did I eat that didn't make me feel good? I'm like, oh yeah, like I just need to return back to X, Y, or Z. But what will always throw you for a loop, and I think what always throws me for a loop, is like traveling, right? Or even sometimes work will throw me for a loop because they're like, hey, we're going to lunch, right? And while some people understand that we're on a different meal plan, everywhere you go, there's not always chicken and rice. There's usually at least chicken, right? But if you're like, oh, I just want like a little veggie or a little carbohydrate, sometimes you can get them, sometimes you can't. And so you're like, oh, I'm going to substitute this carbohydrate for this one. And quickly you'll find out if that's a good or a bad idea. And so for me, I'm like, okay, how do I reset? How do I focus and say, okay, I've been following best practices. I veered a little bit from my best practice, going back, and I feel much better. So for me, it's actually easy just to say, I just feel rotten. Like I don't feel good. And so for me to just go back and say, okay, I know why I don't feel good and fix that has been a little bit easier for me. That may not be the solution for everybody, but for me, I just know I feel different.
Yeah. What would you recommend to somebody who's going through that process but feels like they can't get back to it? Because I know I've had that challenge at times, whether it's specifically with a meal plan or, you know, some other area of my life where I'm like, I know that I've done it before, but for whatever reason, I can't seem to make those same choices and have that same discipline. What advice do you have?
Congratulations, you're a human, right? Like a lot of people, I think if they veer from something, they're like, I'm a total failure. I made a mistake. How can I come back from this? Right? Like, congratulations, you made a mistake. Like, it's okay. Right? I think the first and foremost thing is you have to give yourself a little bit of leeway. When you're in a position where you are trying drastically to change your life and change your lifestyle, right? Like if you accidentally fall and like eat a donut, that's not the end of the world. If you trip and land on a piece of pizza, you're going to be okay, right? It's allowing yourself a little bit of like leeway to say, okay, I'm a human being. I made a mistake, right? There's bigger mistakes you can make than like eating something bad. But allowing space in your head and even in your journey to say, yep, I did that and I'm going to return back to it, and giving yourself that power over that thing, whatever that was, and go back and say, yep, had that happen, and have the power to go back and get back on track. Right. When you have those moments of, I don't know, can you trip and fall on a donut? If you can, I would love to, but it's like when you have those moments of weakness and you may have eaten something, don't get so hard on yourself. It's okay. Right.
Yeah.
Just recognize that like, great, that was fun for a second. It tasted good for a second or, you know, the beverage was great or whatever it was. And it's okay. I'm back at it, right? Like just recommit to yourself and say, yeah, I did it. It was fine. I didn't die. Right. Like it's funny because like I've actually been terrified to like drink. Like I promised Kris I wouldn't drink a soda, but I've been terrified. Like Because there's a couple of times I've been really tired driving, and I'm like, what if I just like stop and get a soda so I can stay awake? And I'm like, I probably wouldn't die. And, like, I have this weird struggle in my head, right? I ultimately don't. But because I'll find a pro, like I found just last week, we went down south and I found like a protein shake at the gas station, right, to wake me up a little bit. But I think that's first and foremost, whenever I help somebody, because a few of my friends are also on health journeys and I'm helping coach them, allow yourself some room for a little bit of a mistake, right? Get back on track. And what you'll see is like, oh my gosh, you'll have these moments of taking that control back, right? A lot of us, I think, are in a journey and we feel like we're beholden to a habit of some sort. And somewhere along the way, you have to break that habit. And if you inadvertently go back and drink a soda, life's good. Just go back to not drinking a soda, right? Mm-hmm. And so for me, I think it's allowing yourself space to say, I made a mistake. I'm not a bad person. I didn't do a bad thing. I'm fine. And just reconnect with what your why is and get moving.
I love that idea of giving yourself space, because I think we generally give space for other people way easier than we give space for ourselves. And I know that I've had quite a few conversations with Kris in that same regard of feeling, especially as we were getting going in the very beginning, I felt a lot of like guilt and shame that the choices that I had made had put me to a place where my boss had to make a whole YouTube production and all of this big, amazing thing to try to help me get back on track. So I felt a lot of negative emotion around that. And that was some of the first coaching that he gave me, was that you have to give yourself space for the journey that you're on, and to recognize that even the fact that you're saying like, okay, I want to get better, I want to improve or get back, that's the hugest step, like to even recognize that and want to be different. And then giving yourself space to go through that journey makes all the difference. Another thing, just to kind of piggyback on here, because I think it applies to all these different areas, Kris is really big about trying to find a way to improve and level up a little bit every day. In fact, I've heard him reference a couple of times that he considers that to be a definition of divinity, like how every day you try to just be a little bit better and always be improving. So that has been critical for me in not only getting started, but then on any place that I feel like I've gotten something a little bit out of whack, just to make like those little baby steps to turn the momentum or to turn the ship and get back on course. I think that's been really helpful.
Yeah.
You mentioned that you've been helping one of your friends go uh-huh. through some similar types of health journey paths.
Yeah.
And that brought up another thing to me that I think could be something to answer Josh's question. I always find that when I teach something, I tend to cement those behaviors and ideas permanently for myself.
For sure.
So what have you seen for helping your buddy? How has that impacted you on your journey?
So you're exactly right what you just said, right? Like when you get the opportunity to go from a student to a teacher or a mentee to a mentor, right? You get the opportunity to say, okay, like I'm going to put this thing and really solidify it in my own life so I can like help somebody else in their journey. And so for me, it's given me an opportunity to say, hey, listen, like I don't have any room for error in my life now, right? Like, because I'm helping somebody else and I'm holding true to what I'm doing, right? It means that like it reconnects me to my why, right? Like if I get off track just a little bit, I'm like, okay, I gotta help my friend. And so I need to make sure that I'm doing everything possible that I can do to make sure that I can give him best practices as well.
Yeah. Yeah, I've been conscious of a number of times. One of the reasons why I feel like I didn't make any progress towards my health journey previously was the fact that I didn't really feel like I had a support system, accountability buddies, people to go to the gym with and ask questions. But I've realized that I wasted a lot of time when I feel like the universe does a pretty good job of answering back. It's been a mantra of mine recently. The universe always answers back. So if you don't have like that support system, or you feel like you don't have any of these things in your life, I feel like you can go out and become those for other people, and the universe will find a way to turn that back to you. So if you don't have a support system that you feel like, right, can just be there for you, go out and be somebody else's support system and watch how things change. So teaching it to other people and being those things for other people. We talked about the importance of writing things down, being able to remember them. What other thoughts do you have on being able to reset or get back on track and help to make things permanent?
You know, we kind of hit on a couple of the big ones, and even one that hits. So helping my friend has been an amazing thing for me, but even bringing it closer to home, one thing that I love that I've been able to do is I begin to identify, as we go through these breakthroughs with Kris, right, and as I begin to identify, like, limiting beliefs in my own life, right, whatever that's based around, my ears have been opened a little bit, a lot bit, to, like, what's happening under my own roof, right, with my children and with my spouse. And I get to say, oh my gosh, like, I not that I'm perfect at it, but I'm like, that right there is a behavior we need to stop right away. And I've called a couple of my kids out on that, right? I'm like, whoa, like, hang on a second, right? Like, you're going down a dangerous path because of the terminology that you're using. And I would love for you to switch it to this, right? And so for me, when it comes to, like, resetting and just even moving forward, it's like, okay, now I need to, like, identify spots in my life where other things are happening that are not in harmony with what I'm trying to do. And so if I'm at home and I'm hearing my kids use words like, you know, I can't, and whatever other negative words that are associated with not moving forward, I'm like, oh, hang on. Like, let's talk about this, and let's talk about why we should change it from this to this, and the difference in your life that it will make from going from this to this. And so it's been a really cool opportunity to kind of reset not only myself back to, like, good ways, but my family as well, and say, and give them some training and some coaching that I never would have done before I started my health journey. I never would have paid much attention to limiting beliefs or can'ts or shouldn'ts or stupids, right? Like, or hates, right? Yeah. Like, I still, like, I'm the same boat as you. Every now and again, I'll work out and I'll be at Kris. I'm like, I hate this. He's like, what?
Yeah.
I'm like, oh crap, I'm in big, big trouble, right? And so it's the same for my family now, though. I get to, like, take that same mentality, that same behavior, and go back and say, okay, we're going to live a better version of ourselves simply by listening to the words that we're saying and what we're putting out into the universe, right? And so that starts with me. And so, like, if I know that I'm getting off kilter, if I've had a bad day at work, if I've had a, sometimes you have a rough workout, right? Like, it's like things just aren't clicking or you don't feel right. Like, I have to go back and try to be in my peak state because I know that there's other people under my roof that are counting on me for leadership and guidance to make them better human beings. And so that's one thing that will snap me back as well, is saying there's other people, not just me, that I have to worry about. It's making sure that I raise a really, really good generation, right? And so that'll snap me back pretty quick too.
That's so good. I love the concept under there of consistency. And while you're not beating yourself up when you have those missteps, that there's got to be something fundamentally inside of what you're trying to do that drives you to just keep getting out, keep making steps, keep making moves, work on improving a little bit better every time, maybe a little bit, you know, in my case, like a few fewer sleeves of Oreos.
That's right.
At any given time. But I think that is what I would kind of summarize my thoughts on this topic. Like, as you continue to work on it, you'll be able to be more consistent. And then with more consistency comes more consistency, right? The more that you establish that track record for those decisions, then the easier it is to get back on track when you've let things go, and never, ever giving up. One of my favorite movies of all time, The Goonies. Goonies never say die, never say right? Die.
That's right.
And I've had that as something that I say to myself all the time. Like, there's a lot of things that I feel like I don't get right, but underneath all of it is this idea that, like, Goonies never say die. So to Josh and anyone else who's kind of in that place where you feel like you've made some decisions and maybe you're off plan, how do you get back on? I'd give you that. That'd be my takeaway. Goonies never say die. Give yourself space for those mistakes and recognize the progress that you have just in wanting to get back at it. And then a little bit every day, take steps that are going to get you towards your goal. Maybe it's not the straightest path, but as long as you're right, pointed in the right direction, you'll get there eventually. So thanks so much, Casey. Great conversation as always. Appreciate you guys for tagging along. We'll see you on the next episode of Wait and See.